In my last step that I want you to do, I want you to work with the grammar and spelling checker. Particularly, what I want to show you is how to set your preferences to look for style errors as well as actual grammatical errors. So in Word, you're going to select Preferences and Spelling and Grammar. And you typically want to leave check spelling as you type. Always suggest corrections. The standard portions are generally pretty much okay. I'm going to get into writing style, and I'm going to choose technical. And then you want to go into your settings, and I like to have everything checked. This one's really important to me personally. Your writing is much clearer if you write in an active voice. And when I was in college, I had an instructor who took off 5 points every time that I used a passive sentence. I didn't even know what a passive sentence was. You might not either. In a passive sentence, you are unclear as to who is doing whatever action the sentence is doing. You don't really need to know that for this exercise, but I do want you to make sure that every different option is checked. Jargon can be a big deal when you're working with computers and other technology things. So by using the technical writing style and checking all of the possible errors, it helps look for errors that I might otherwise overlook. I'm going to choose Recheck Document, and I'm going to hit Yes, and I'm going to hit OK. So I'm going to go through and use my spell checker, and if you're using one that's built in here, you can just right click. The green squiggly line lets you see what the error is. Green is grammar, red is spelling. So I can just look for my errors here. And I deliberately left a few in there. This is an example of a passive voice. I'm going to choose ignore. I'm going to ignore the use of the first person because I actually want that in here. So you want to go through and make sure that you don't have any obvious spelling or grammar errors. Make sure you do that before you hand it in.